What is up, guys? Zach Scott here, playing Plants vs. Zombies 2, and right now I'm showcasing the Jack-O-Lantern. It's a brand new premium plant available right now for $6.99, which I believe is what the electric blueberry cost. But the Jack-O-Lantern, heavy damage, a three-tile range, but a sluggish recharge. Jack-O-Lantern spray fire down a lane, doing extensive burning damage over a short distance. Usage. Tap him for a single flame burst, tap and hold for a more powerful flame jet. So that's going to be really interesting. Boo! Mwahahaha, opines Jack-O-Lantern. Oh yes, things and stuff are scheduled to be seriously spooky when he's around. Count on it. So I'm going to be taking the Jack-O-Lantern across various eras and seeing exactly how he plays out. I've never used him before. I didn't even watch a video about him, so this is all new to me. I'm going to start off with today's pinata party, which, by the way, we're doing the Lawn of Doom theme right now, and the special edition Jack-O-Lantern is here. So let's go ahead and just get right into business right now. Hopefully it'll give us a Jack-O-Lantern to try out. And we'll be able to see what happens. Here we go. Tap Jack-O-Lantern for a burst of flame. Okay. Tap and hold for an extended burst that does increasing damage. Could be really, really interesting. We got a lot of the classic, Halloween zombie skins back. There's a spore shroom, which we showcased in the previous episode. I don't know where to put what, but we're going to start off right here with the spore shroom. Maybe the Jack-O-Lantern can go down here. And so let's see it. If I tap it, he does a little thing, and if I hold it, he just kind of just does it. How long can I hold it? That was about it. Okay. Gonna definitely want to try out the Jack-O-Lantern on this guy because he's coming in right now. A single burst seemed to do a good job. So I'm still trying to think of how I'm gonna handle this. So put these guys down. That seemed okay. I want to go ahead and try to burn him to maybe a crisp. He's just walking on. What's the boost for him? Oh wow. Ghosts are haunting everything. Can we please burn him for real? Why isn't he burning? I don't understand why he's not burning. Let's burn this whole section though, maybe. I don't understand why the imp wasn't burning. I really don't understand. Okay, we're gonna go ahead and start placing these all over though. Let's do the special on the Jack-O-Lantern again. Looks like we have several ghosts just haunting in specific rows. What, a parrot just took that away. Apparently. Okay. All right, I'm gonna go ahead and start haunting them here. Oh man, okay, that's fine. Let's keep it up with the whole, the spore shroom business here. Here, we're gonna go ahead and place that down. Interesting for sure. All right, that's a large spot. That's pretty efficient. I don't know, what else can you ask for? That's pretty good. Especially when you have so many, I guess, but it's crazy. Okay. Let's go ahead and unleash something like that. Let's unleash a Jack-O-Lantern attack. They're just haunting. That's crazy. All right. This is great. I'm thoroughly enjoying this Jack-O-Lantern party that we're having here. We tap it once, and you can tell how much flame he has. Like, you can tell, right? You can tell how much flame he has, obviously. I'm assuming you can tell. Putting these things all the way down. All right, hold it down. We're gonna focus on the gargantuar here, the Frankenstein gargantuar, pouring out as much as I can. Pouring it, there we go. This actually seems pretty useful. Of course, in real practice, his recharge rate is going to be a little bit different, so we're probably not going to get to rush out this many Jack-O-Lanterns. So I kind of like it. I like how its range is limited. I mean, that's a good balance for it. It's really strong. 500 coins sprout and a new costume. Yes, I'm glad I got a new costume. That was the first pinata party that I played for the Lawn of Doom. The Lawn of Doom. That's a new costume for the Stalia. The Lawn of Doom has been out for a while. a few days at least, and that was my first time to give it a go. This video will be showcasing the jack-o'-lantern, so let's find out. Let's go ahead and take it into... we'll take it across various eras. I'm not so sure, you know, what to showcase about it. I have a few questions about it, that's for sure. And if there's anything that's kind of odd, like Big Wave Beach might be a little bit odd to think about, but I'll bring it in there as well. We're going to do level 22, and I don't know what we're going to be looking for exactly. We can't have too many plants. I can't plant on Dave's mold colonies. That should be fine. I'm going to bring in the Grave Buster. I'm hoping that what ends up happening is... not that the Imitator is what I want. Where's the Grave Buster? What I'm hoping to find out is whether or not the Jack-O-Lantern can take out the graves. So that's one question that will get answered here. I almost want to bring in the Intensive Carrot to bring any back, but I'm hoping to protect them, so... Maybe we'll keep hoping for some protection there. I'm going to bring in the Ghost Pepper, another Halloween favorite here. I think it came out close to last Halloween, if not on Halloween. I'll bring this in as well. And if we're going to have a lot of coins, which are, you know, a lot of sun, maybe the Cherry Bomb might be a good choice as well. We can't have too many plants at once, so we're going to try our very best to deal with this. So let's see what we got here. We're going to put the flowers in the back. That should be good. Actually, I might put the jack-o'-lanterns in the back. Put the flowers on the second row here. Second available column, I mean, not row. Go and freeze them just to start allowing us to prepare a little bit better. We're going to get rid of another grave in this in that second, or aka fourth column right there. Should be good. And I kind of want to take out the four that are there. And so what I'm going to do is hope that this works. I think it will. We'll take out that zombie and also maybe a couple graves. I'm just going to leave him there. I'm not going to dig him up. I'm going to freeze him. I think he'll take out the grave just fine. Yeah, there we go. That was suitable, in my opinion. And then, again, focusing just on all these graves everywhere. I am getting out my economy pretty well, pretty fast. I'm going to go ahead and put that there to stop him. I'm going to probably just hold it. Let's see what I can do. I'm going to go and freeze him. And yeah, we have a pretty long recharge rate. And the reason I'm holding it is because why not? I'm a little worried about how this is going to play out, but should be okay for now. And that took out the grave as well, which is good. I'm going to freeze him once more. I might just deploy a cherry bomb on these guys. Seems appropriate. There you go. And, you know, we could... I'm just going to go with the flow here. Things seem to be working okay. We luckily have them on all the rows we need. So let's start deploying it. Can I hold two at once? That's a great question, and it seems to work. Beautiful. All right, now this is gonna be really interesting. Obviously, I don't think I can do much. I'm gonna start him off. I'm gonna start slowing him down with that. And it might not even be a bad idea just to freeze him in the ghost range. And then when this conehead guy gets up here, well, he's gonna get exploded a little bit. What happens if I tap once? Good enough for that, for a regular one, right? All right, we're gonna go down here. I'm not gonna waste any, you know, anything that I can use. If that's going to be what it feels like I need, that's what I'm going to use. He walks really fast, so I don't like that. These guys seem to be walking pretty fast, so I'm going to tap that. I'm going to tap that. I really wish I would have grabbed that, but I didn't. So let's see what I can pull off here. Again, can't be too hesitant. Let's hold both of these down for an extended period of time. And then this one down as well, which... could be a test. That's great. That worked. I'm not going to mess around with these tile guys. Let's go ahead and get them done. Get them taken care of. Start them off right there. And then I'm going to hold both of these down and just try to, for what it's worth, take them out. There we go. It worked. I'm pretty happy with the jack-o'-lantern right now. It seems pretty powerful. Let's go ahead and unleash a super, see what we can take out with this. That seems to be pretty good. They are definitely feeling the burn there. Very cool, very, very cool. I'm liking this a lot. Boom, take out a few more. We're gonna start with the ghost there. Done, okay. And I don't really feel a rush to put out, you know, many more. So far this seems to be working okay. I'm gonna have to start, you know, it's kinda hard to multitask here, but I'm gonna start holding on to these two. There we go. Don't take my sunlight, please. Let's unleash on these guys a little bit. We almost have another cherry bomb left, which is going to be useful. Can I plant a cherry bomb on those? Indeed, I can. Yeah, let's start out. Here we go. We're going to hold this down. Good job. I'm going to go ahead and... There we go. And like I said, this is just working out really, really well for me. This definitely takes some time, though, to get used to, because it is a lot of work. It is a lot of work on behalf of the user, so could be really intriguing to see how this plays out on some other eras. For ancient Egypt, it worked. It was very active, but that's all the plants I needed. Very, very interesting plant. I think it's probably more powerful than the electric blueberry. Way worth the value compared to the electric. Way more value than the electric blueberry, rather. But that, you know, we still have some more eras to take it across. My Zen garden's thirsty. I might want to go ahead and just dip in there and water it. Let's do that because it's been a long time since I've actually checked out the Zen garden. Let's do that right now. You need to do the Zen garden every day. You really do need to water this every day. You get your plants boosted. You'll get coins. There's no reason to not do it. It's just something that, you know, I don't mean to neglect, and I pay the price for neglecting it. I could have way more powerful plants more often, but I neglect it sometimes, and I shouldn't do that, so I apologize to the viewers who are expecting me to have more powerful plants all the time. Let's take the jack-o'-lantern, and again, like, when we go across these eras, the one thing that I always do on Pirate Seas is I take it to this level that's kind of like a farming level. Now, the point of the farming level is basically you can set it and forget it, and then, you know, pick up any things if you hear it. But this one's going to be a little bit different because this is a much more active plant, the jack-o'-lantern. And so let's see how we do with it everywhere. This is restart. Last time I had a setup that just didn't work. The spore shroom, I was wondering if it could work all the way through, and it worked like beautifully for like the first half. And then with the spore shroom, it just all kind of fell apart. I don't know if you guys saw that, but it did. So no, I don't actually... It's so weird. It picks part of them. Anyway, we'll bring that in. Oh, I guess because only part are available. And it doesn't really matter what else we bring in. I just don't want to bring in anything else. So there we go. I don't want to bring in anything that's boosted. So let's bring all these in. We're only going to place the jack-o'-lanterns, and we're going to put them in the far back. Now, the problem with the jack-o'-lanterns is that they won't be able to strike down the cannons. They won't be able to strike down the cannons, and I'll prove it by putting one up front, although that probably won't help too much. Let's rock. I do wonder, though, when we have a bunch of cannons out, I'll use a super on the jack-o'-lanterns, and I'll see if that works. Obviously, right now, having the garlic in play makes me... Yeah, that won't reach, but that was a good one. Having the garlic makes me think of a play that you could do with the jack-o'-lanterns, which would obviously be to, you could, in theory, basically divert the zombies into particular rows that you know, want, and you place the jack-o'-lantern there, and it should be good to go. Now, this is going to be interesting. I'm going to have to, like, hit, like, several things at once. I want to see if a single tap is going to be useful for this, so... Single taps are adequate, so I actually have the tablet turned a different way right now. Single tap, these guys. These are all single taps. Again, this isn't so much of a farming stage as it is now a very active stage. All right, that, see, very active, very, very active. Now that we have all of these out, let's use a plant food on them. and see if we can actually haunt the cannons. We actually can. So with the super that it gives us, you can actually haunt those cannons pretty well. And I'll save that for later. The single tap, I'm liking that a lot. The single tap works. Very, very good. Just a very, very good premium plant overall. And I think you're able to see just how useful it is. I mean, this is just amazing. This is a really amazing plant. I would really hate for them to nerf it later, but, you know, right now it's an amazing plant. Look at that. Look at that. It just tears right through them. It really does. No doubt. Oh, my gosh. This is where you tap all of them, and sure enough, it takes out all of them, and this might be a good time to use some of the, there we go. Sure. There you go. Take out a few of the cannons. Why don't you? So this is a very active level now. And we basically only have the jack-o'-lanterns in the back for backup, you know? Tap all of them, get it done. Great. All right. Very good. This is a very, 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 very good plant. I'm liking this plant a lot. I would say I would love it. Oh, dear. Look at this. It's just a very active plant. It requires a lot of work on behalf of the user, but it's worth it if you can do it. You know, if you have the energy to do it, then it's worth it. It just requires a lot of upkeep. In terms of interaction, player interaction. It would be interesting to have a plant that required upkeep in terms of sun, like it always just cost sun. That's something that I've never seen in Plants vs. Zombies 2, a plant that like is a drain on your sunlight. Wouldn't that be crazy? There we go. Well, there we go, guys. Again, you have to be active for that one, but it works. It works for sure. You can do Pirate Seas Day 22 with just that plant, probably just one row of, or one full column of that, of the jack-o'-lantern. It's hard to tell. I'm beginning to see that I'm not going to have to showcase every single era, because obviously there are just times in which, you know, it's going to work the same no matter what era you're in. But one thing I kind of want to showcase in the Wild West is the fact that the jack-o'-lantern affects the row. And so, if you can put it in one of the mine carts, you're going to be able to move it back and forth. And so we'll show that on level 23. All right, let's try it out here. I already have a plant selection. I was testing some things out, but this is what I'm trying to go with right now. I don't want them to lose, you know, I don't want them to trample anything. So what I have now, the lightning's useful. I'm going to bring in the, there we go. The repeater is going to be even more useful, I think, because I'm going to be able to put it on that, on the conveyor belt, the mine cart rail. And so I'm going to focus on the economy a little bit and then try to drop down one of the repeaters or maybe even the pumpkin on the rail. We'll find out how we want to do it. It's just going to be a matter of time. Hopefully we can drop in. Since we are showcasing the jack-o'-lantern, maybe I do want to try to get that out as soon as possible and put it just right there and then see how it works, you know, just see if it can be big and awesome. He's getting really close. I want to deploy the pumpkin immediately. And there we go. Oh, what? Oh, so see? Look at that. That's what we just learned. That's not... Oh, that is so weird. You can... So, that's odd because that's one of the only... I don't understand why you wouldn't be able to plant him on the rail carts. That's the thing. I don't understand why. Well, so I'm glad I actually brought it to the Wild West because now I know. Now I know that you cannot plant jack-o'-lanterns on the rail cart. So that's why I do take these across all the eras. And I said before, you know, like I don't see the point of bringing them across all eras. So I feel like I've kind of locked myself into it now to showcase, you know, because I thought surely you would be able to put a jack-o'-lantern to the rail car. Why wouldn't you be able to? But you can't do it, so that we learned our lesson there. Far future, you know what? I have a notification from Showtime Anytime. Thanks. New episode of Homeland, whatever. I don't even watch that show. So, let's bring them into the far future. See what we're up against in the far future. The thing I'm most excited about bringing the jack-o'-lantern in is the Dark Ages. Like, I, for once, finally want to play the Dark Ages with a jack-o'-lantern. Was level 23 the level that I usually do, or was it the previous one? It's the one where I gotta make a lot of coins, and I love that. This one spend no more than so much money, which could be good because the jack-o'-lantern is very cost-effective if you're able to just take them out. Let's do the jack-o'-lantern on this one right here. I am curious. I'll have them on the reds. And if we don't want to spend a lot of money, then that's fine. If we don't want to lose... Was it... You don't lose plants too? If that's the case, then maybe I don't want to... What were the terms and conditions? Does it say? I said them out loud, but then I forgot them pretty quickly. What I'll do is I'll bring in an ice, and if it gives me a warning, like, hey, whoa, buddy, you can't be doing that, then I'll know. I'll bring in an EM Peach as well. We'll see what we're up against. I don't remember what the stipulations were. I'll just bring in everything that I usually bring in, and we'll see what the stipulations are. So, the jack-o'-lantern, we kind of want to see, you know, for $7, basically, we kind of want to see how well it holds on its own, and that's going to be a large focus of that. So, what else do we want to bring in as a test? Let's just bring in some other stuff. Okay, no, it wasn't about losing plants. I forget. What was it? It was... Okay, no. Okay, yeah. Don't spend so much sun, and you can only have 15 plants. So yeah, the sports room would be something you don't want to bring in here. Just saying right now. So this is good. I'm going to put the flowers right here. I'm going to have the jack-o'-lanterns well represented. It's free, so put it down. There we go. Again, not wanting to spend a lot of money, but I still kind of want to get my sun like as quickly as possible. So let's get some of these out here. Let's focus a little bit. I'll take anything, really. Here we go. So one jack-o'-lantern right there. And who knows, like, what if they have a rule where, like, you can't plant that on tiles? That would be horrible, but I guess technically it's possible. There we go, got him down. And basically I'm just going to be saving it up for more jack-o'-lanterns. We're going to be able to place one in the bottom very, very soon. There we go. Again, I'm going to go for, like, the whole, the whole column of jack-o'-lanterns. Do not worry about me. That's what I'm going for. Got him down pretty quickly. We got two more rows, which is unfortunate, but we're going to probably... I can see myself freezing this guy first. Let's freeze him. We'll place a jack-o'-lantern. And this isn't too slow. You know, some of the plants are really slow. This one isn't that slow. Like, the time warp is super, super slow. This one is not that slow in the grand scheme of things. Really, the downside of the jack-o'-lantern is it requires your control. It requires it. Like, you can't do anything with the jack-o'-lantern. It's kind of like the banana launcher. You cannot do anything with the jack-o'-lantern without purposely controlling it. So, that is kind of intriguing. Let's freeze this guy really quick. And so, as a test here, as the conehead approaches, what I'm going to do is I'm going to do a single tap. If a single tap works, I'm going to be surprised. But I think it's going to be the case where you're going to want to hold it down. So, single tap the conehead. No, it didn't work. Okay, that's fine. Hold it down. Let's EMP the whole squad here because we're in some dire... There we go. All right. Come on now. Hold both of these down. We got them. Beautiful. So the jack-o'-lantern is pretty useful, right? I'd say so. I'm gonna freeze this guy just so he doesn't line up the same as these. It's easier on the fingers. So we do have a lot of sun left. Well, we have 725 sun left, so let's hold these down, take them out. We're gonna have a plant food. Towards the end is when I'll start using those plant foods to make attacks with the jack-o'-lantern. Hold this one down for a little while. We're just gonna want to deploy. I guess here we go. Ian Peach. Sure. Freeze him for a little bit. We're gonna have three rows I'm gonna have to press at the same time. Starting now. Got him. Oh dear. So this is something right here. This is something crazy to think about. I'm gonna have to tap him. I'm gonna single tap all of these. There we go. We took out all of those guys. We did not even need the impeach, which was good because we were out of the impeach. I'm gonna disable them now. Now that they're there, I'm gonna tap on these two. I can't tell if they got them all. Now tap on these two. Pick up the sun. So let's see. Is it one more tap for this guy? Will he be done? This guy seems pretty strong. I'm gonna freeze him. I'm gonna let that jack-o'-lantern charge up a little bit more and then just go after him. So we'll see. We'll see, all right. I kinda want it to wait, but here we go. Unleash it. There we go, we got both of them. Unleash these two. We're just tapping this one. As you can see, this is great. The jack-o'-lantern requires precision control, basically. I would disable him, but I don't need to. I'm gonna maybe disable him. I might use the impeach once they get closer. I don't know what my plan is right now. I'm gonna let them get closer. I have not been spending money, sun very much so. There we go, keep them up. They're both down, great. All right, we need to be a little more careful. Single tap there might do the trick. Single tap there, and there might do the trick. We got them all. Beautiful work. So yeah, this is just working out extremely well, especially in the far future. Especially, jack-o'-lantern is a good plant to use if you're limited on the number of plants that you're allowed to have, as we've just showcased. And now they have a lot of plants left. We're getting down there towards the end of the match. I might want to go ahead and say, hey, I'll deploy something. Because look, it's gonna power on the far future, it's gonna power like everything. It's gonna take out like the whole field. It's gonna be crazy. Very cool. Oh, see, actually this guy's still alive. So let's go ahead and expend some of the jack-o'-lantern there on him. Man, that guy's a tough cookie right there. I am curious about the football mechs. Haven't really got over to those yet though. But I am curious about them. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna try to just hold on to all of, or let's do these two. There we go. I don't know how my tablet's gonna like me trying to do all five, you know. All right, so this is interesting. Let's do this. Let's see if we can take out the majority of things here. And maybe we can't. Maybe we still have to expend a little bit. There we go. Beautiful work, really. And this looks to be maybe like the last guy. Hard to tell. Let's start lighting this whole thing on fire. Yeah, we sunk him. There we go. Wow, so the jack-o'-lantern's great in the far future. Right now, the only era that I don't really recommend him in is the Wild West, because for whatever reason, you cannot place him on the mine tracks. That is so weird. It's just so weird. But anyway, let's do Dark Ages now, because, I really, really want to see what the Dark Ages has in store for us, because I have so much trouble with the Dark Ages. We're going to bring him into this era, see if there's anything that, you know, needs to be... my worries, of course, they'll get turned into sheep, obviously. We have the perfect stage in Dark Ages to tackle. It's the hardest stage, I think. It's day 16. It offers you everything the Dark Ages can throw at you. Now, the only thing that I can really, really think of for the Dark Ages is that it's going to be difficult to get these out early. I think it will be difficult to get these out early. We can't bring in sunflower. I guess we can't bring, I don't know. I'm going to bring in the mushrooms. I'm gonna bring in, you know, the imitator. I am gonna bring in the Grave Buster this time. That's one thing that I forgot when I showcased the Spore Shroom. Had a lot of difficulty with it. The fact of the matter is, it just might be tough to bring out the Jack-o'-lantern in a timely fashion. But we'll see. I'm also gonna bring out the Ghost Pepper, a great temporary damage thing. I could also bring out the Freebie Mushrooms. You know, why not bring out the Freebie Mushrooms? I think those would be good. Actually, you know why not? Because I'm probably gonna prefer having... the magnet shrooms. Truth be told, let's rock this. Let's see if we do well. It's gonna be a lot of work. This is gonna be a lot of work. If it works, it's gonna be a lot of work. And I don't know if it's gonna work, but I'm gonna try to make it happen. So let's do it. Let's start putting down the mushrooms. The jack-o'-lanterns are gonna take the forefront. The mushrooms are gonna be maybe hopefully protected by everything. It's just really tough to know. I'm gonna start off freezing them. I'm gonna just focus so hard on the economy right now. Plant these mushrooms, hopefully they expand and grow. And we shall see. Here we go. So far, we have four mushrooms out. Again, I'm going to try to stall as much as possible initially, just to... Now, he's far back. Maybe he's fine. I don't know. Okay, now I'm going to have to stall even more. What I'm probably going to do is start, really considering putting out a ghost pepper for the top row. And then stall that guy. I don't know, I'm expending a lot on mushrooms right now. A lot. I'm going to dig him up because I want all the extra finances I can get. If I can... what should I do? What should I do? Maybe that right there? I'm lost. Maybe that wasn't the best choice. Let's freeze him. I'm going to have to hold down this. Oh, dear. All right, we're going to put that there. We are going to put the ghost here, maybe, I'm guessing. Help. Anyone have any ideas? I might want to let him explode. Hopefully he'll explode and take out something here. Jack-o'-lantern, single push. Go ahead and dig him up. We'll deal that. Dig it up, please. We don't want anything too crazy. Oh, dear. Okay. Necromancy. Unfortunately, necromancy is happening. All right, so this is going to be an intriguing... There we go. We got that. All right. We're going to put him there. Going to freeze him. The very hands-on, you know. Start this up. So far, so good. I'm really enjoying this. How come I didn't eat that? I don't understand. Oh, dear. Okay. Yeah, as soon as that's done, I should be set. Alright, we're gonna have to set the tone down at the bottom. Hopefully it works. See, that didn't quite work how I wanted it to, which is unfortunate. Can I super... Okay, that actually worked. That's great. That's great. Okay, so far so good with this. Okay, we have... Okay, here we go. That'll get rid of the graves. That'll give us some suns. Wow. Okay, yeah, very much, a lot of work here. All right, got rid of those jack-o'-lanterns. Nicely done, Zach. And really, this is just working out very, very well. I'm really happy with how things are going with this. I was super excited to bring these into the Dark Ages, you know? All right, let's actually use a super really quick, because we can probably do a lot of damage right off the bat with this. And I think we did, and that's great. Yikes. Oh, dear. Yeah, I don't know. Yeah, got him. Okay, that actually worked. Let's use the ghost on that wizard. Hopefully we can get some of our items back. Please. This is going to be so terrible. Okay. Yikes. Okay, so that wasn't quite as awesome. Now that he got through, that wasn't quite as awesome. That worked, though, and I'm able to put another one down. I really just want to make sure that these guys can't have their hats. But they keep taking them, and it's just so depressing. Here we go. If we can destroy them while they have hats, then it's great for us, so... All right, we might be able to do some damage there as well. And having these jack-o'-lanterns keeps the bad guys away. Here we go. There we go. See, the necromancy is a problem. I'm gonna go ahead and put that there because I don't know how else to combat it, but we have to hold down all three right here. A single tap for the bottom. Again, the jack-o'-lantern makes this, if you want to play with the jack-o'-lantern, be prepared because you're going to have a much more active game. For sure. I tapped the magnets for a second. Oh, geez. Okay, hold this down. There we go. Lovely. Holy cow. And see, the problem with a lot of that right there, let's do it, here we go. I really should have haunted. You know what? That's what I'm forgetting. I'm forgetting that I can haunt like crazy. Oh man, okay, here we go. Gosh, so much, you know? Got him. Here we go. Oh man, I'm gonna have to haunt this guy. Yeah, okay, there we go. Let's haunt. I think it's called haunt when you use this, I think. I don't know. How should I know? It's a great level though. Let's haunt again. We have, it's like the final wave. Let's just haunt. Let's see who all we can take out really quick. We can take out this guy too. Like I said, the jack-o'-lantern makes this such a crazy, it's way more active, basically, is what I'm saying. There we go, right? There we go. Take him out. There you go. Wow. And again, that was primarily the jack-o'-lantern's doing. Of course, we got great, tremendous help from the ghost pepper as well as the magnet shrooms. Like I said, I was excited to play Dark Ages. After having the limited experience with the jack-o'-lantern that I just did, I was thinking in my head, yes, this is going to be good for the Dark Ages. And sure enough, it was. We did really well. It makes everything really active. The Big Wave Beach might be a big problem, but I don't know because I haven't taken it there. I could have beaten the Wild West stage, but my point was made. You know, you couldn't put it on the track. So what are we going to run up against in Big Wave Beach? Let's find out. Basically, we want to test it. Now, I don't think, you know, the thing about this, obviously, is that we're going to have to deal with the water. So let's take it to the most advanced stage that we can think of and just start, you know, toying around. I'm not excited about it at all. I don't think we're going to win it with a jack-o'-lantern. I think Big Wave Beach is not the place for a jack-o'-lantern. But we'll find out. Don't lose more than 5 plants. You know what? Fine. That's an okay challenge for this. The key though for me is gonna be, you know, I'm gonna need the sunflowers. I'm gonna need, you know, anything that I can get my hands on. I'm gonna need these things. The ghost pepper can be planted right on there. It's great. Right on the water. It's great. Jack-o'-lantern premium plant, please. Let's see what we can do. And then the lily pads, if we want to kind of expand outwards a little bit. We pretty much have everything that they can throw at us here. You know, my main concern is, you know, can I rush out here and get the jack, you know, get everything done? That's my primary concern. Can I rush out and get everything done? My dog is whining right now. She wants outside. Ashley's outside. My dog's fine. So, this looks like a good solid start. You know, what else do we want to do? It's okay, Ari. It's fine. What else do we want to do? You know, one thing that could be interesting was it would be to boost the jack-o'-lantern. But, you know, this is not the stage to do it. I don't know what stage to do this on. This is a problem. I don't know what to do is the main problem. Why is she whining so much? Okay, I'll be right back. I'm gonna attend to her. Be right back. All right, my next plant is going to be maybe the ice, just in case I have to freeze everything. So let's rock with this. Whatever, sure. Doesn't matter. Using power lily counts as losing a plant, whatever. I'm not even thinking about it. I'm just thinking about how am I going, yeah, so the ice might lose a plant. Whatever, we'll be fine. We can lose 5. I don't know what to do. I don't know what's going to be best. Of course, using most of this stuff is gonna count as losing a plant. So whatever, I don't know what's gonna be best for this. What I'm curious about is how the jack-o'-lantern interacts with the water and can the jack-o'-lantern be planted on a lily pad? That's what I'm concerned about. So we're gonna take it easy a little bit, maybe. This guy is just coming in without much care. I'm gonna put this there. I wanna see what happens. You know, I could put a lily pad there, sure. Oh, it's boosted. Oh, I forgot that it was boosted. All right, let's tap it. Wow, the jack-o'-lantern works on the water. And see, if I would have just discounted this, it's like, doesn't matter. It doesn't matter if I bring this in. Then I would have not known that. So I'm glad I brought it in. I'm glad I now know that. The problem, of course, is going to be how do I get more jack-o'-lanterns right now. I need them right now because I did not bring in a lot of things. And losing plants is not what I'm prepared to do. Let's just go ahead and lose a plant. I think this counts as losing a plant. That does count as whatever. It's fine. My main concern is getting out as many jack-o'-lanterns as possible. And already they're like on the opposite rows. It's super annoying. There's like too many on the opposite rows. There's just no way for me to really do this unless I get a plant food or something, but it's just not gonna work. Ugh. Yeah, so I guess what I'm sad about is that this, you know, I'm not gonna be able to rush out these jack-o'-lanterns like I really want to. That counts as losing one. That counts as recharging. I lost another one. Yeah, I'm losing lily pads. So this is, okay, this particular stage isn't good for jack-o'-lanterns. Let me go ahead and come back. I'll do a different stage. That particular stage, if I'm focused just on using jack-o'-lanterns the whole time, it's gonna be very difficult. But let's bring it in. That was 28. Let's try 27. I wanna see what the rules of 27 are. So level 27 might be, what is level 27? Let's see. With most of the plants picked for me. That's gonna be interesting. We pretty much have everything that they can throw at us, including gargantuars. So they pick most of the plants, right? Well, I'm gonna pick one too. It's gonna be the jack-o'-lantern, obviously. And yeah, I'm gonna bring in the power lily as well this time and imitate it. So let's do this, let's rock. Most plants pick for me, sure, let's go. How do we wanna handle this? Good question, I don't know how to handle this right now. I feel like I wanna put the jack-o'-lanterns further up, but I really don't know how I'm gonna deal with the fishermen guys, so I haven't quite figured this part out yet. I am gonna put down something for the economy, that's fine. I feel like I need to somehow quickly get 500 in order to deal with it, but again, I don't know. Put that down, we'll be safe, sure. He's gonna be in the front, and you know, what I'm gonna like most about this, I think, is the fact that I can actually use the jack-o'-lantern from a lily pad onto the water, which I cannot believe. I can't believe that you can't put them on the tracks, but they work in the water, so. Whatever, it's like a kind of a mystical fire that they're doing, and the mystical fire leads me to a question, which I hope to have answered very soon, but I haven't quite got to that point yet, and already I feel like I'm lacking a lot. I really needed lower level plants to come in here and take these guys out, and that's kind of the problem with the jack-o'-lantern. You know, you're going to be dealing with a plant that's not necessarily going to be good for you. Ugh. So wait, okay, block him. That's what we're gonna do, we're just gonna block him. Maybe not the best choice, but sure, it's gonna work for now. And then once he's done eating it, maybe I'll be ready to plop down a jack-o'-lantern or something, I don't know. Should have enough for a jack-o'-lantern. Right now, we're gonna hold this one down. There we go. Oh man, okay, hold on. There we go. Okay, he's still eating away there. You know, I think I'm gonna have to block right there too. Oh, okay, hold on. Got him. I'm nervous though, because obviously once they eat that, I'm gonna have to react quickly. As soon as I have enough for a jack-o'-lantern, I need to just probably dig up the walnut. There we go. Got him. And of course, the big problem is going to be like what happens when I, you know, need to start putting down even more stuff. You know, let's see, let's do it. I even take out the guy underwater, which is phenomenal. I like that. Hit him once. Hit him once, probably. Now, these helmet guys, probably twice. Yeah, the long one. Oh, man. Okay, him once. Him twice. Okay, cool. Once. Got it. Okay, so this is an intriguing, just a very intriguing thing overall, because you don't expect this to work. Okay, already what I want to do right now is plop down a jack-o'-lantern. Ugh, he's gonna pull me. Oh, while I was using that too. That's horrendous. No! What the heck? Oh, I forgot all about this guy down here. Like I said, the jack-o'-lantern is a very active plant, so it really sucks sometimes, doesn't it? I might just let her come through and do whatever you need. Low tide, yikes. Oh, hey, single tap there. Nope, ate it already, darn it. Single tap there. Where's gonna... No! Oh my god, I forgot all about this. Here we go. Here, free him, thank you. Hold it down, how long do you need? God! This is why maybe this isn't the greatest. I'm going to put down this banana thing, take him out. Sure, oh, see, and I missed it up there too. Gosh, man, single tap. Ugh, okay, I hate missing it that often. So sure, take it out, whatever. Jacqueline in there. Ugh, okay. Basically, my goal is going to be... All right, now what? Okay, I don't see any, please take, oh my god, okay. Okay. Good deal, kinda sorta not. No, sing, oh darn it, I see. Again, it's with the whole, like, how. I just keep forgetting about them, you know? Alright, come on now. There we go. Oh, crud. Okay, what are they eating? Oh, they're eating, okay, yep, pulled him right in there. Darn it. Gosh, this is like way too much. Like, and then plus controlling the, this is hard. Tap there, hold it down. Make this work, please. Please take him out quickly before anything else happens, thank you. They're taking out the lily pads all over the place. Please, please get him before, thank you. Final wave for some reason. Up, 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 banana. All right, let's do it. Burn him before he gets here. Oh man, he's gonna actually get here. That's fine. Whatever, ride it all the way out. It doesn't matter to me anymore. Oh, brother. Okay. All right, tap the banana guy. Can I still win this? Oh my gosh. So that was crazy. Oh my god, that was really hard. But the thing that we learned is the jack-o'-lantern actually works in Big Wave Beach. You learn something new every day. And when you play Plants vs. Zombies as much as I do, you're still learning things that are new. It's just insane. I cannot believe it. Let's continue onward. So what are we going to learn next? I mean, what's after Big Wave Beach? We got, is it Frostbite Caves after Big Wave Beach? Because we could definitely learn something. Now, I don't think I'm going to learn anything on Neon Mixtape Tour, to be honest. But Frostbite Caves, okay, I'm not going to play this all the way through. I have one question about Frostbite Caves. I know that we're already, like, almost an hour into this. I'm not going to play this all the way through. My question is, since the Jack-O-Lantern is kind of like a fire-based thing, does it defrost plants? So that's my main question. That's really the only thing I think I'm going to learn from this. So let's bring it to level 26, which is a stage that I often do when I showcase plants. And will the Jack-O-Lantern basically defrost plants? That's all I want to know. That's all I want to know. I know it'll melt the ice of, you know, the guys that are frozen, but will it defrost plants? And that's honestly all I need to know, because I know that I'll be able to take out all these enemies just fine. It'll be fine. But my question is, will it defrost plants? And that's it's a good question. I'm gonna bring in the hot potato, and I will bring in, sure, I'll bring this just to compare and contrast. But what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna drop out as soon as I can. I'm gonna put out a jack-o-lantern. How am I gonna do that? I mean, because it's gonna take some time to actually get up enough sun to put them out. So I guess to answer that question quickly, I mean, I guess I could just say, yeah, one more sun is all I need to know. So we'll find out. That's the only question I have. I'm confident that I'll be able to, you know, defeat this stage using any means, other means. This is a jack-o-lantern. It does. That, see, there you go. It emits heat. And, you know, it melts plants. So that's great. Answer has been answered. That makes it a very viable plant to use in this case. Very, very viable, in fact. Because all you need to do is let him, you know, get down to a level like that. And boom, he's done. Now, you know, I'm kind of curious what's going to happen if I just keep playing this, because I said I wasn't going to do it all the way through, but now, I mean, I'm kind of curious. If I don't have any long-range weapons and those three guys in the back never defrost, you know, what's going to happen? So let's find out, shall we? Because I'm interested. I can put a ghost on this guy. I mean, that's a single tap. It's not a single tap. How many taps is it? Okay, that's fine. Oh, see, I should have done this. Here we go. Yeah, got him. Great. All right, so what do we have to do? Got him. We really just have to be ready. I said I wasn't going to do it, but like I changed my mind on the fly because I was surprised. I didn't think he was actually going to. There you go. Questions have been answered. I'm gonna need something for the top row, like when the dodo bird comes by. This is really interesting. Hold these down. Oh, see, he switched. I wasn't expecting that already. But I'll have enough funds to put this down and hold it down for a second. Now, here's a question. He damages in air. Oh my gosh. Okay. So that leaves me with a question. I mean, I'm playing much more than I thought I was going to. I'm having questions answered just like astoundingly. And it's quite interesting to be learning all this stuff about it. So I'm good right now with the... Yeah, I'm going to put that there. Just start weakening them. Maybe I don't want to deal with them right now. I don't know. All right, let's unleash. I will need that unleashed as well. This does great against the ferrets, or the whatever they're called. I can't believe this is working out so well. This is so great. I don't even want to use the super, because those three guys in the back are all charged. Or not charged. What am I saying? Charged? Oh, I somehow use a super, though. I already think. All right, never mind. I take it back. I'm going to have to... Oh, man. Okay, so he was using his super. Oh, that was lucky. That was so lucky. Because I went ahead and used the super. Like I said, I wasn't going to, but I did, and then while he was using a super, I was a little bit scared. It was a little hard to deploy some stuff. Boom. Here we go. Come on, please. What the heck? Okay, so something happened. I wasn't able to hold him down like I thought I was. What the heck? What happened? I don't know what happened. I don't understand in my head what happened there. I messed up holding him down or something. I'm surprised that he can affect that dodo in air. I did mess up holding these guys down. I don't know why. Final wave, though. If I mess up like that again, I mean, it's over. Maybe was I just out? I could have been out, I guess. Which is definitely a danger that I face here. Oh dear, yeah. Look, I'm running out. I'm out of that one again too. Managed to pull that off though, and I left two. I mean, if I hadn't used the super, then all three of them would have been there, and then they die at the end. So, I mean, it's a little risky sometimes to use, you know, jack-o'-lanterns if you're not going to be as nimble as you think you're going to be. So, I definitely some things slipped through the cracks there. So now, my question is on the Lost City. Will the jack-o'-lanterns take out the air guys? The insects flying in the air. I think they will now. But I don't know. Let's go ahead and bring it in. We'll bring it into the hard level over here. And they should be good against the Porter Gargantuars as well, I hope. But level 29 is the stage that I like to do. And, you know, they should be good. They should be good against everyone. The Shovel Guys, the Umbrella Girls. They should be good. I am curious about the Airborne Guys, though. I'm still going to want to bring in the Blover to get rid of them quickly. But I probably want to test one of them out. Just one of them out. We'll bring in the jack-o'-lantern, we'll bring in the gold leaf, wherever that is. We'll bring in the ghost even, we'll bring in the ice even. And then we'll bring in the gold. Again, this is going to be primarily a jack-o'-lantern focused stage. This looks good to me. I could see intensive carrot being useful. If I need to quickly replant a jack-o'-lantern. But we'll see. We'll see how it goes. But actually, you know what? I want the Blover. I do want the Blover. Where is it? Where is it? Blover, where are you, buddy? Where is he? See, they changed the backgrounds of all these, so it makes it harder for me to find. There he is. Alright, we got this, I think. I don't know what I'm going to use the lilies for, but we're going to start off with the flower in the middle. The main problem that I'll have here is deploying the jack-o'-lanterns fast enough. That's going to be the biggest obstacle that I face. But hopefully we'll get it done. All right, right there would be a good spot for it. I could slow him down. I think that's going to be wise if I start slowing him down. I'm going to want to put in a jack-o'-lantern right there. It'll give us a little more sun. Drop in another flower. Twin sunflower. And we will see what happens. And I think this is a single hit, right? Single hit. Great. Love it. Now I'm going to need a couple more jack-o'-lanterns. ASAP, really. As soon as I can. Oh, see, I did not even mean to tap that, but that's fine. I'm gonna go and put that there. I'm gonna go and freeze her. I would love to have another jack-o'-lantern as soon as possible. It's just a matter of getting him, you know? I think my economy will be fine enough to support having one. It's just a matter of having that recharge, and he's just about recharged right now. There we go. And I don't... Okay. There we go. Got him. I don't know why you couldn't put the jack-o'-lantern on the tracks. I really don't understand why. Maybe, you know what I bet it is? Okay, now here's the test. Will he take out... They do damage airborne, guys. Let's get rid of the airborne, guys. Good test. I don't really want to test it all the time. Here, let's start right now with that. Got him. Excellent. Goodbye, airborne, guys. Thank you. So yeah, this is phenomenal. We're doing a good job. Oh, hold on. See, it's kind of the thing. It's hard to time this sometimes, maybe. Oh, geez. Okay, hold on. Oh, he just got read straight up. Oh no. Oh no. You know, that's probably the worst thing I've seen yet for the jack-o'-lanterns is when that happens. The crystal guys just blew him away. I'm not prepared to come back. I'm not prepared to deal with this. I was not prepared. Flatly, simply, plainly, I was not prepared to deal with that. Should have learned, should have known, but let's get rid of the few that we can. We're gonna end up losing a lot right now. Oh, we end up losing. We lost everything. We lost literally everything. I can't believe we lost everything. Thankfully, I had a decent whatever built up, but no, we lost everything. That was a straight up assault on my jack-o'-lanterns. They took them all out, and I lost everything. I really did. They're gonna, yeah. Is this the final wave? I don't even know. Does it even matter at this point? Because I literally lost everything. You know what? Do another one. Yeah, that didn't even do what I wanted it to do, so I have to be super careful with how I gotta focus up on the top rows really quick, right now, basically. I gotta just focus on the top rows. I can lose everything else, but I can't lose that top row. I should be fine. Really, I should. Okay, got him. You know what? And I'll probably be able to take him out as well. Sure. Preserved one lawnmower. So, there we go. We got some questions answered about the jack-o'-lantern. Definitely, definitely did. There's, defeated some Porter Gargantuars. 37 left. I cannot fathom taking on 37 more Porter Gargantuars anytime soon. But that was good. Last but not least, Neon Mixtape Tour. I can't think of anything that's going to throw me off about Neon Mixtape Tour, but it's going to be useful to bring the jack-o'-lanterns in. Like I said, there's a surprise every era thus far. There's been a surprise every era. But so far, I think the jack-o'-lantern is the premium plant that's most worth it in recent memory. I've had a lot of fun with it. It's very strong. Let's go ahead and see what level 28 is all about. This will be the last level we tackle. So let's do it. Let's see what we got. All right, everyone's just kind of skate in, I guess. I mean, this is a problem that we face. We have a common setup. Can I just cycle? Oh, they're giving us the intensive carrot. Interesting. So I want to imitate that thing right there. What else do we bring in? The ghost pepper's good. The ice is always good. Jack-o'-lantern is the showcase here. That's what we're showcasing. The ice is good. You know, if we want... Oh, time warp. Love it. I love the idea of the time warp. Let's do it. This should be good. Yeah, and really, I don't have anything that really justifies having a time warp, but it's going to be intriguing anyway. We're on day 28. We're going to see how we can do. At least that's my goal. Start off with some flowers. We're coming. Zombies are coming. I'm going to start off just freezing them immediately, just to focus on the economy a little bit more. Again, like I said, it's something new all the time, every day. Well, that guy is definitely moving in. Put that there in preparation for him. Freeze him anyway. Slow things down. Ah, no. No, that's not what I want at all. I'm going to need to somehow bring out a bunch more jack-o'-lanterns, and that's not going to be fun. So he's... Oh my gosh, I cannot interact with the jack-o'-lanterns. Oh, there they... While they were up, I could not interact with those jack-o'-lanterns. I can't interact with jack-o'-lanterns as long as they're playing that music. Let's take him out. Taking him out quickly. Oh boy, okay. So we have a lot of these things coming in. Crazy enough, huh? I Okay. How do we want to handle this? Oh, jeez. Okay, so they're drastically affecting me right now. We're gonna time warp. I couldn't do anything. I couldn't touch him. You know, I just couldn't touch him. Oh, that won't even reach. Let's see this. We can get rid of that arcade there. There we go. That arcade's a little bit out of reach, but I can do something, maybe. Definitely a really interesting thing. Boom, sure. Like, how many guys can we take out, right? See, I can't control it. He's dead. No. Man, he's pumping out the music so loud and I can't do anything. Here we go. Please. Oh my gosh. Here, we need a time warp. There we go. Time warp's proving to be useful. I kind of dislike how, you know, I can't really control some of this stuff going on, but it's okay. I'm gonna focus down here. Just put the guy down there, maybe. I don't know. Gosh, they're so loud, and they're stopping me from doing anything. Time warp. Jeez. So even, you know, the jack-o'-lantern works pretty well on Neon Mixtape Tour, along with the time warp. You know, I'm not having very many problems at all. Jeez Louise, though, man. Here we go. Boom. Sure. Get those guys going. All right, got him taken care of. I can't control anything like this. Can I freeze him really quick? Because I really want to be able to control these guys and take on these guys. There we go. Final wave coming up. I'm just gonna go ahead and do whatever it takes, you know. All right, great. I'm gonna... Just the fact that they're able to do this is infuriating. Like, that they can just disable my plant. So that's really cool, though. We got to, again, there's been a surprise every single era. I'm glad I've taken these across every single era. What we saw is that the jack-o'-lanterns can be completely disabled by the boombox zombies here. And so that's interesting knowledge for sure. We've learned a lot of stuff taking the jack-o'-lantern across all the eras. Hopefully you appreciate this video. I did my best to showcase the jack-o'-lantern. You can use this video to make a decision whether or not you want to purchase this premium plant. I'm leaning towards, yeah, definitely. I did it. I really like this plant a lot. This jack-o'-lantern is probably one of the most useful plants I've utilized in a long time. Thanks so much for watching. It's been a long video, but come back next time for more. I'll see you then. Goodbye. I'm Zach Scott. Subscribe if you have not. If you like this video and want to help this channel grow, all you got to do is click the like button below. Thanks so much for watching. Check out more of my videos. And if you want to find me on your favorite social network, check the links in the description. And here's Otto. That's Egon. Those are my cats.